Welcome back. Time now for our monthly pulse check of the state of M&As in the country. The first half has seen an uptick in deal volumes, but then again, valuations are less compared to the corresponding periods of 2011 and 2010. Although outbound deals have reduced both in volume and value, inbound deals have managed to increase in volumes. The Vedanta Group restructuring also added to a jump in mergers and rejigs. And this is, of course, in comparison to what happened in the previous years. Raja Lahiri of Grant Thornton India now joins us with the findings of the deal tracker report. Raja, thanks so much for joining us on CNBC TV 18. Sure. If you analyze then for the first half, has the going been much tougher than the corresponding last 2 years, say?
Yeah, absolutely. The going has been pretty tough in this year. In fact, this is the lowest in terms of the M&A deal value compared to the last 3 years, and we are clearly seeing a slowdown in terms of the M&A. I guess what is interesting to note in this year, you've got a significant amount of restructuring and internal mergers happening. Out of the $25 billion of M&A that has happened, close to $15 billion is coming from internal mergers and restructuring. Clearly the largest ones are the Cesar Goa, Cesar Sterlite one, which is $12 billion. And the Mahindra Satyam along with Tech Mahindra. So clearly, you know, that's kind of the trend that we are seeing. From a cross-border perspective, inbound is down, outbound is down, because obviously we're not seeing the larger deals happening. The sentiment is currently weak. You know, obviously the environment, the growth rates, the GAR and all of that is clearly impacting the deal momentum.
Right, Raja, but sector-wise, what really performed for the first half of the fiscal?
See, if you look at the sectors, you know, there are some themes that are coming up. You know, mining clearly saw the Cesar Sterlite, you know, dominating with a $12 billion transaction. In terms of IT, ITAs, we saw Entity from Japan buying out Netmagic, which is an interesting deal from Japan, and the TechM Satyam merger. In the pharmaceutical space, we saw Piramal buying the asset in the U.S., and in the banking financial services sector, we saw HSBC buying out RBS, which was approved by the RBI. So that's for us as the M&A is concerned. But if you look at the private equity space, there are clearly some themes that we are seeing. You know, healthcare remains a very dominant sector. We saw some pretty good deals happening with Vasan Healthcare, with DM Healthcare, so, you know, and with Care Hospitals. So healthcare theme continues to be robust. In the IT, ITS sector in private equity, clearly internet is the favorite of the season. We saw Warburg putting in money in Quikr. We saw Flipkart getting $150 million from Axel. So that's clearly favorite of the season. You know, and in the financial services sector, we see a clear trend in the private equity liking the NBFC space. And with Warburg again doing two good deals, in terms of Future Capital as well as AU Financials, clearly the theme, you know, we feel it will continue going forward.
Raja, one last question. You said restructuring and rejig sort of the first half of the year, but what's the outlook going ahead?
I think we are definitely seeing a slowdown as far as M&A is concerned. Liquidity is tough. The environment is not easy. But I believe that, you know, this is actually a great time for private equity funds to look at investments in certain sectors, because valuations could come at a sensible level. And I guess from the corporates, especially, you know, from the larger corporates in the IT, ITS sector, you know, it's a great time for a value pick in the US and the European market. So I think strategically thinking, this is a great time to do acquisitions. However, you know, it's just the sentiment possibly which is pulling the brakes as of now.
Right, so sentiment's not very positive. Thanks so much for that, Raja Lahiri. That's, of course, how Deal Street performed for the first half of the year. Well, with that, we're going to wrap up Reporter's Diary, but stay tuned. Markets Today, up next.